So, in vlog, coach vlog number 9, you are going to dive probably deeper into the way you approach your archery than you ever have before. Even if you are a super healthy person, either this will reaffirm what you're doing or open your eyes to partly how the body works and where you may be holding yourself back as a competitive shooter, as far as your food intake, and maybe even create some questions or some future discussion on what you should be doing to prepare for future tournaments or even long trips, hunting trips and stuff like that. I really honestly think that this conversation may prompt a change in the environment of the competitive shooter, both for bare bow and the other disciplines within archery. I want you to know that I've known Dr. Buddy Touchinsky for a very long time. He's got a brilliant mind, and that, you know, the idea is necessarily for the bare bow project to just not, you know, maybe give you a few tricks along the way and some drills and things to make you a better shooter, but we really want you to be better human beings, and we want you to be as healthy as possible, because we need you around as long as possible. So our goal with this vlog, and eventually maybe a series of these types of things, is to provide those opportunities to you. We want to provide you with the information, solid, researched, backed up, proven information that's going to help you. All right, everyone. Well, welcome to Coach Vlog 1859.3. I don't even know, but I'm having this vlog because a lot of people have been following me on Facebook, following the podcast, and know that I'm participating in something that's called the Metabolic Reset. So to explain really quick, I had Dr. Buddy Touchinsky, who's on the podcast, say hello, buddy.
How's everyone doing?
Buddy had joined us some time ago. We had a discussion on the physiological the neurological responses and how it can affect target panic. In the last 31-ish days or so, I had started something with Buddy called the Metabolic Reset. It's a weight loss program, but you know, I don't like calling it a diet. And you know, a lot of people have heard me talk about how as archery athletes, we need to treat ourselves just that way. And for those of you that are out there that maybe struggle with a weight issue or staying in shape or a program or an ability to get healthy, that's what this discussion is today. This discussion is a healthy way for you to make progress relatively quickly and learn how it's going to affect you in a positive way and then help your archery ultimately get better. Just some background. So 31 days ago, I started this Metabolic Reset program. We're going to run through some details, you know, the basic premise of what that is. To this date, today, I have lost 35 pounds in just literally 31 days. I think that's what it is. So it's over a pound a day. I feel amazing. My energy level is through the roof. And there's a maintenance program that comes at the end of it, so that you don't fall back off the wagon, per se. That's the only way I can explain it. So, Doctor, I'm so used to calling you just Buddy. Dr. Buddy Touchinsky, where do we start to say what the Metabolic Reset is? How about this? Tell me who you are, tell me what you do, and how this program came about.
Sure. And I guess we'll start with going back about a good 12, 13 years now. And I've shared this on my social media feed. It's a picture of me at the beach and with the shirt on. So it's rated PG, but it's me and my wife in a photo. And I forget when I was scrolling through, but you could just see like both of us. And my wife, Susie, she's kind of tall and lanky to body type, but even her face was puffy. My face was puffy and bloated. And I remember thinking back to like, how much did I weigh at that time? And it was about 238 at my peak. And that was probably about 29, 30 years old. And I'm a chiropractor. I have my own chiropractic practice. I work for myself and I'm in business. So I also think back to like how I was feeling at the time. And I remember letting files pile up, saving them for the end of the week, a lot of procrastination. I wasn't very proactive in my business. I was comfortable, but I wasn't really growing it. I wasn't really pushing. I wasn't really learning new things. And for some reason, back at the time, I was just like, I feel like crap. I grew up playing ball in my life. I played college ball and got out and worked out for early 20s. I'm in grad school, but I was somewhere in grad school where I just became overwhelmed in a way and just really busy, stressed out, stress eating, booze, and just all that stuff that comes with that. And when you're in your 20s, you can kind of, you can really abuse your body and make it through. But then right around 30 is when it really started catching up with me. I started really gaining the weight. I'd stopped working out at that point because of being in business and being busy there. So at some point, enough was enough. Yeah, we're all there. Enough became enough. I started CrossFit and I lost some weight. So I dropped some weight down, but it wasn't that much. And because I wasn't really paying attention to what I was eating. So I found this diet program. And it's basically a template we use today. And I lost 21 pounds in 21 days. I remember hitting it like right on the button, 21 and 21. And I just felt really amazing on it. And so I cycled back off that program and back on it a few more times and kind of played around paleo and Whole30 and some of those other things. And then I hit the program hard again a couple of years later. And I found myself around like 215, which was much better than how I felt at 238. And that kind of got me on the path of like, this is pretty amazing stuff and no one's talking about it, especially we're in a rural area and the lifestyle here isn't quite so great and our health statistics aren't quite so great. A lot of my chiropractic patients were having issues with chronic pain, diabetes, heartburn, IBS, I mean, you name it. So I'm like, I need to start spreading this message. Hooked up with a health coach that we're still together today with Jess. She runs our programs and does a great job there, but we decided to design this program that could help people enjoy the same benefits that I did. And those benefits were just tons more energy. Having the ambition to go out and grow my business, staying involved in CrossFit, then getting into powerlifting and weightlifting and just doing a pretty good job there, at least for where my ability was at the time. And just feeling good overall. And so now I sit today, I joined you guys in your most recent program, started 215, I'm about 200 on the button today. And I'm always amazed because it's probably been about a year since I did that actual program. I've done some other stuff in the meantime, some fasting here and there, but it always amazes me. Like once you start feeling your body correctly, how good you feel. So we started to about a month ago, middle of the pandemic, everyone's gaining their quarantine 15 and myself included, I gained about 5 pounds and it's like, okay, we need a change and it might be a good time to help others. We were beyond the panic stage and we felt like, all right, now might be a good time to try to get people back on track. And hell, if we're opening the economy and some of us might get hit with COVID-19, we know that hypertension, we know that diabetes and metabolic issues, we know that obesity really puts you at a disadvantage if you're exposed to that. So we started our program. We had a big group go through. Jess was adding it up this morning. So I don't have the exact numbers, but we're at well over 1,000 pounds for the entire group, which is amazing. In addition to lots of other benefits that we'll talk about, but yeah, so that's where I'm coming from. And just here to kind of share the word with everyone else. And I know it's going to help your audience as well.
Yeah. I started the program at 272 pounds. I shot indoors this year. I shot some of the best archery I've shot probably in my life. As a bare bow shooter, shooting no sights and really being part of the bow and trying to break in the entire process. It's amazing that I even had the performance that I did because like when I look back on like you were saying, like just lack of motivation, tired all the time, foggy, you know, sore constantly, knees hurt, ankles hurt. You know, there's just this, there's all these ancillary things that accompany you with a poor diet, overweight. Not to mention, like, my blood pressure wasn't horrible, but it was not great. I mean, I bet you after 3 cups of coffee, I was in the mid 140s, you know, on the regular. And, you know, my standing blood pressure was, while overweight, was high 120s to mid 130s. And, you know, it just, I don't know, just, it was going down the wrong path. Enter COVID, school teacher, online learning, business shut down, this podcast responsibilities, coach responsibilities, competitor, family, business, blah, 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 blah. I don't know. They just keep stacking on. And, you know, the response was drink 3 beers a night, eat whatever I wanted, and just be unmotivated, right? So you hit the nail on the head with the idea of when to start this thing. And it came, my wife and I both wanted to do it, but I just knew that if I want my archery, if I want my ability to really focus on what I'm doing, be at the top of my game, I knew that there was, and I always talk about, like, archery form, like if there's a kink in your archery form, it's going to find it. Your shot process is going to find that kink and it's going to get exposed. Well, one of my kinks was my weight, my food intake, and my body in general. It was not healthy. And, you know, so this, no competitions, everything shut down. I mean, some small stuff, but nothing major. I was like, now's the time. So Memorial Day, we started, and that was the last day of us. There's a loading period to this, and I don't know, you don't have to go into full detail on what the program is, but, you know, we had a 2-day loading period, and then that's when you change your diet. It was on day number 3, technically, of the program. And the loss started right away. Huge adjustment was the amount of water. I needed to be disciplined in the amount of water I was drinking and stuff like that. So I guess that's where we get into the, dare I say, meat and potatoes of the program. What is it? How does it help you? What does it do to your body? And then we're going to transition into how can this help you as an athlete? Okay.
Sure. So yeah. So to talk about the program a little bit, we always ran it as a one-on-one program. We always had, like, group start dates because we have a Facebook group set up, and it's always easier when you're doing it with a few friends or a few people. And at most we might've had like 20, 25 people start at a particular time. And the problem with that is it's difficult because we're meeting with people once a week for a session, for a phone call. And Jess and I, we only have so many hours in the week, so it's difficult to kind of arrange and be able to talk to everyone like that. And Facebook group's there for support from others, but there's various degrees of participation there. So for the past 3 years, we've run the program, and we've ran it pretty successfully. People have gotten great results, but we felt like there was a next level to it. And you mentioned COVID and the stay-at-home orders and all that stuff. It kind of presented a challenge for all of us, but on the other hand, a unique opportunity because now everyone knows what the heck Zoom is. I mean, before this, you're a teacher and you do your coaching online, but a lot of people, like, you tell them, you give them a Zoom link, and 9 times out of 10, you'd have to message them on Facebook and say, hey, click on this link. And they're expecting a phone call or an email or what they're expecting. So it allowed us to use technology to bring a lot of people together, which is cool too, because we're all isolated. We're not seeing a whole lot of people. And I mean, human beings are tribal beings. We need to be around others, and we need that group support, that tribe. So we decided to say, hey, let's try a big group. And instead of having individual calls, let's have group calls. So let's get 10, 15 people on a small Zoom chat once a week to have our weekly check-in and see how people are doing. And we can share their stories, share their struggles, in addition to what you're sharing in the Facebook group. As part of private Facebook group, but it's still, it can be intimidating for a lot of people. So the Zoom calls, we don't record at all. We don't save them at all. We allow that time for people to share as much or as little as they want. And what we found was that it really worked the way we intended it. And people were sharing struggles, helping each other out, kind of connecting even offline and saying, hey, let's get in a small group, just the two of us, and we'll, or three or four of us, and we'll keep each other on track on an almost daily basis. We have the Facebook chat. I mean, we have over, between past participants and the current ones, I think we have like 180 people in that group. So people are posting recipes, they're sharing their, we ring a bell, we post a GIF of a bell or a picture of a bell for every 5 pounds lost. We're seeing that on the feed daily. So now instead of just scrolling through Facebook and seeing all the BS about COVID-19 and all of the, just the arguments about all of that stuff, and we have the riots and political BS, and now people have, hopefully at least every once in a while, they see a bell scroll through and it's like, hey, Frank lost another 5 pounds. Isn't that great? Or even people that are struggling and they go on there and they say, hey, I didn't lose 5 pounds yet, but oh, that person said they lost some inches. So I'm going to measure myself. Like, oh yeah, I lost 2 inches too, even though I didn't lose as much as I wanted to. So just putting that program together, having it in a group setting like that, we get that power of the community. And also we get to charge a lot less than we normally would. So it makes it way more affordable for more people. Whereas perhaps price might have been a hindrance in the past. So the nuts and bolts of the program, the meat and potatoes, is it's a diet program, diet change program, lifestyle change program. We don't like to call it a weight loss program, even though people will lose a ton of weight on this. And our average weight loss across the board, highs and lows, averages out to about 20 pounds over the 6 weeks. But where I really think we excel in, and we, from day one, we don't focus on the weight loss or the diet part. We focus on the mindset change and the lifestyle changes, because we don't want to be, I don't want to be someone that sees someone in the supermarket a year from now. I see Frank back at 280 and it's like, yeah, that worked, but I just gained the weight back. We want to create changes in mindset and change in habits and routines and make it sustainable. So the 6 weeks, a little hardcore, anyone can do it, but it's a little hardcore, not sustainable long-term, but we have the focus from day one to how do we take this, reset your lifestyle, reset your routines, reset your taste buds, so that when we get to the 6 weeks, we'll loosen things up, and then it makes it really easy to follow long-term. And oh, by the way, you get to stay in the Facebook group, so you get to see all the future groups going through and get to see all the successes others are having in the future to perhaps keep you on track. We do have a specific, very specific diets program, and that's usually necessary when making changes. I've done gradual changes. I've done really strict changes. The strict changes work. I mean, there's a reason why people don't go to rehab, the Betty Ford Clinic, and hit the crack pipe every other day or wean themselves off it. It's like cold turkey. And then you follow a program, you have group support. So with food, it's almost like the same way as addiction support. You need to have that group around. You need to have some sort of support. You need that accountability. And then you need a specific program to follow, and you need to kind of cut some of those habits cold turkey. And like you mentioned, COVID, a lot of things are changing now. What better time than now to change and make, to have a reset? We go through life kind of on these automations. We go to work, we get up, we go to work, we come home, get up, go to work, come home. We do have 5 days a week. It's like, oh, hey, it's the weekend. I get a day to relax. Sunday, you start worrying about the next work week. And then you just repeat that week after week, month after month, year after year. Next thing you know, you're like 60 years old and you're tough, you're in rough shape, and you kind of just grinded your way through most of your life. Well, COVID made us kind of hit that control alt delete and kind of shook us to our core and woke us up. And I'm hoping that we can use this time to, you can either look back and people ask 5 years, 10 years from now, what did you do during the COVID-19 quarantine shutdown? You can either say, I drank wine every night and binge watch Netflix and had snacks and gained 20 pounds. Or you can say, hey, that's when I really made a ton of changes. I did a reset. I changed my lifestyle. And that's why I'm so good to this day. And so that's the way I like to look at the current scenario.
Yeah. I mean, it just makes this, it actually adds a simplicity to your habits of eating food. It makes it simple. It doesn't make it complicated, because you know when that the proverbial question, oh, what are we gonna have for dinner tonight, you mentally switch gears to, one, it's not as important what you're gonna have,
as long as you have something. And two, you're more proactive to just already have some option available. And I'm looking forward to the conversation of how it can affect, you know, looking on a competitive side with archery. And I said to you, I think I said this to you off camera. Archery is plagued with above average athletes that would be high advanced athletes if they would take as much control of their life and their diet and other things, if they would pay attention to their health as much as they pay attention to their archery. And you can look up and down a shooting line at any, and I was one of them. That's why I can say it. I was one of them. You can look up and down the competition line and probably see that in the numbers of America, what's our obesity rate in America? Do you know off the top of your head?
I think from mild obesity, I don't know if it might be 60%, moderate to severe. I think it's like 30%. So
I'm willing to bet that the you go to a tournament with thousands of people that 60% number holds true. And you got to look at, you know, you can be passive about your archery and not really care, but if you want to be a high-end athlete and you want to address everything in your game, how can this help you? How can this 40-day stint become a lifetime change to make you not just a better, healthier human being, but improve your performance as an athlete?
Yeah. So the 6 weeks, I like to say it's not the conversation. It's the start of the conversation. And so that's just to get people kind of on board and show them how different they can feel. We all go through life, and this is part of my story, was it was just like over a period of time, probably 10 years, maybe a little longer than that, where you just kind of slowly decline and you don't really know how bad you feel until you feel good again. And suddenly, like you shared with me, I don't know if you mentioned it earlier, but within a week, your energy was already through the roof.
I didn't share that here. I shared that when you and I were recording prior, but my energy level within 3 days went straight up. And because I even like private messaged you, I was like, is this fake news, or am I like, I literally feel better already. Still, I'm hungry, but, you know, drinking water. And you're like, no, that's about right, but it's going to continue and it's going to get better. And I was like, and that's one of those where you step back, you're like, yes, you know, this is good, you know. But go ahead, keep going.
Sure. Yeah. So when you go from what you felt like before, which is probably not so great, to all of a sudden within a few days feeling great, that's a night and day change. And it's a sudden change versus, and it's the old fable of the boiled frog, where the frog jumps in the cauldron of water over the fire and it's a little warm. And it's like, okay, this feels pretty good. Not too hot. Feels pretty good. Add some more wood to the fire. It gets hotter and hotter and hotter slowly. And then all of a sudden the frog ends up being boiled. Versus if you had the really hot water there in the first place, throw the frog in, they're probably going to jump the heck out because it's going to be a shock to their system. Or it's like sitting in a hot bathtub. You get in the hot bathtub, it's like, holy cow, it's hot. You're laying there a few minutes, same temperature, your skin gets used to it, and now you're adding more hot water to make it even hotter. So we kind of have that scenario happen with our health as it slowly degrades over time. And we it's because we're not following the habits that we should: food, sleep, stress reduction, exercise, like everything that goes into a healthy lifestyle. And so you don't know what you don't know, but then you follow a program like this where we have all of that laid out very specifically for people. And then we start to focus on some of the other things. Then all of a sudden you feel great. It's like, holy cow, this is what life could be like. And I go through periods, like I mentioned, where I follow the program and then I'll get off track at times as well. And I almost don't feel it. And it happens at the holidays every time, like Thanksgiving, Christmas, and I get better and better each year, but I still, it's normal human. So you like the cookies, you like all the good stuff, the treats that you get over the holidays. And then I'll usually try to reset myself either by following this program for a couple of weeks or doing just a straight up fast for 2 or 3 days. And then you feel good all of a sudden. It's like, man, it's some people feel like this all the time. And that's where I get into doing this stuff. It's like, I just want to show as many people as possible that here's how good it can be. And we have people in the group right now, and Frank, you know, a few of them that post often. I mean, this guy, one guy, Pat, he's, I'm going to interview him here and on my group, and he's on three different diabetic pills, felt like crap. He follows this for like 5 days, and he had to call his doctor basically every single day, take one med, take the morning med away, take one of the evening ones, take the other evening one away. Now he's on no medications, where before it's like he had no idea. He was just, here's the plan, take the medication, you got diabetes, oh, here's your blood pressure pill, and you got to take this, that, and the other. And it's like, they don't, no one knows any difference. So applying that to the athlete, it's like, you could be watching this or listening to this now and say, I'm a pretty damn good shooter and I'm feeling good and I'm hitting the scores I want, or I'm kind of progressing the way I want, but who knows how much better you can be unless you try it.
Gosh, it's so true.
So this is like a full on immersion. This is like a full on, it's like boot camp. You take a scrawny little kid out of high school and you build them up in those, I don't know how long boot camp is, I'm not military, but you make huge changes in a short period of time. They come out of a completely different mindset. And you go in there like Bambi, you can barely stand up. You get out of there, you got your 12-point rack on by the time you leave that training. And so that's what this kind of is. It's like, okay, follow this, just do it and prove to yourself, all right, maybe you were doing things right, or maybe you were the best you can be, but well, here's how much better it can get. Or if you're not doing it, then most people that join know they're not doing well. When I started this, I knew I wasn't doing well, whether I wanted to admit it or not. But then you do it, it's like, holy cow, this is good stuff.
Yeah, it's oh man, I can't stress enough to those that may watch this or have followed my, because I post about it. I mean, everybody knows I post everything on Facebook and Instagram. But you know, but I post about it because I don't post about it because I want to talk about it. Well, maybe I do, but I post about it so people hear about it because somebody else might benefit from it. And like to the archery community out there, and specifically the barebow community, because that's who I'm passionate about. I mean, I'm passionate about all archery, but like the barebow is such a finicky thing. It's not like everything can affect you into a greater level in barebow because you need all of your senses to be on point for you to shoot your best. Your mind's got to be clear. You know, you got to have as little stress as possible, because every little thing affects the way that you control your shot in barebow, right?
So let me stop you there, and let's dive in that a little bit, because it's really easy to make a connection. And I don't know how others are, but for me, like if I understand it, I'm going to be more likely to follow it and follow it closely. So our cells, our metabolism basically is how our body takes in stuff and then turns it into other stuff. In terms of this, it's how your body takes in food and then turns it into energy, or how it takes in food and nutrients and turns it into muscle tissue or other cells, and how it builds stuff. So basically it's our processing system, is our metabolism. So the metabolism or the function, those chemical processes that happen in our neurons and our brain can be affected by how we fuel it. One is nutrients. I mean, that's an easy connection. If you don't have enough nutrients, that's basically like the machinery, the pieces of the machinery that make the cell function. And so it's like vitamin B12, for instance. You don't get enough of that, you're gonna have stroke-like symptoms. Like that definitely affects your nerves. If you don't have enough magnesium, potassium, your stomach, your muscles cramp up. So the nutrient side, I think that's a pretty clear fit. But fuel side, like why would fuel matter? So if we're constantly fueling ourselves on glucose or sugar, and I'm not just talking sweets, because people will say like, I don't eat any sweets. You eat bread, you eat pasta. Oh yeah, all the time. Toast, yeah, all the time. Well, that breaks down the glucose pretty much like this once you swallow and gets into your stomach and your blood glucose goes up. So what your body will do is it will depend on, or it'll shift to burning more glucose, because our bodies don't want to have high blood glucose. So it either burns it or stores it. If it burns it, okay, it burns it and you're using that for fuel. If you store it, you're storing it mostly as fat, which has all the issues along with body fat, like high blood pressure and diabetes and all that stuff, and just being obese. But the fuel part of it, if sugar is available, your cells will burn the sugar, because that's a short-term fuel. And if you think about it, well, the facts are that you can only store maybe a day or two of glucose or sugar in your body. You store it in the liver, you can store it in some of the muscle tissue, and then as you burn it off, it's gone. and you can't make any more sugar unless you eat more sugar, carbohydrates, and in some cases protein. So your body will want to use that first. Well, sugar doesn't burn as cleanly as a fuel source as fat. So by now, a lot of you have heard about the ketogenic diet, which is a high fat diet. Well, that a lot of that originated, a lot of the research originated in kids with seizure disorders. So if they ate a normal diet and they have tons of seizures all the time, they try meds first. If meds don't work, then they say, okay, let's try the ketogenic diet. 80% of the calories per day from fat, percentage-wise, to fuel your body, and then the rest carbohydrates and proteins. When they put these kids on that type of diet, their seizures go from like 50 an hour down to like 1 an hour or less, because their body's brain, one, they have seizures in the first place because their cells and their brain aren't firing correctly. But by giving them just ketones and having them burn that, it like smooths it out. It's like putting oil or putting dry gas in a motor that's just puttering and spitting and sputtering. So if it does that for kids with seizure disorders, imagine what it can do for the average person or even the athlete. Because the fact of the matter is, the brain cells will burn those ketones better, and that's from fat, than it will glucose. So by eating the proper diet and eating the proper foods, you will tend to burn or have ketones available for your body's cells and muscles and brain cells to fire, which will help with mental acuity. And then one more point on this, and I'll throw it back to you, Frank, but it's a survival mechanism. The fact that we become more in tune with everything, we think more clearly, we have more energy, at least initially. If you go long-term, it might change, but at least initially have more energy, more focus. If that didn't happen, then we would go a day or two without food in the wild back when we were running around the forest. And if we went into ketosis and started burning ketones for energy, if we went the opposite way and got lethargic and tired and all that stuff, well, we wouldn't be good hunters. We wouldn't be good foragers. So it's like nature's way of designing our body. It's like, shoot, we're out of glucose. We're out of easy calories. Let's become good hunters and gatherers and focus. The opposite of true is when you are calorie abundant and have lots of those carbs and starches and stuff like that. That's basically your body saying like, yo, chill, we have enough. You don't have to be a good hunter. You don't have to be energetic. You don't have to want to exercise. Just kind of sit like a lump on a stump, lay there on the couch and chill out, because why waste your time and resources looking for more to do or doing more stuff if everything's already abundant? So it's kind of, we're just lulled into this just obese coma, and it's overfed coma. And I think a lot of people just kind of bounce through life like that, not knowing anything different.
Well, I think what we're seeing in archery, and just to sort of piggyback off of what you're talking about, we're seeing a transition in people taking their archery very seriously, specifically in the bare bow world, with bare bow being opened up in the World Archery Platform and being able to represent the United States team. More organizations are recognizing the World Archery Platform, the World Archery rules, and it's growing, right? So naturally, just like compound and Olympic recurve, bare bow seeing this heavier interest. The thing is that I think we're going, like with what we're talking about today, we'll reach beyond a bare bow. It's going to reach out to those that are serious about their archery. And it's going to reach out to those that maybe aren't serious about their archery, but they really know they need to do something about their diet. The overall benefits of putting this information out there is that we are helping people in general. It's not just archers. It's not just compound shooters. It's everybody. And for me, and here's the big picture for me. It took 5 or 6 years for me to go from 220. I probably hit 280 at some point in time. All right. 220. I'm going to go as wide as my screen is, right? 220, 280. 5 years. It took me 30 days to go 220, 235. Think about that. 5, 6 years, 30 days. It's mind-boggling. And it's doable. And you can do it and be healthy. And then you can get all these benefits. You could be a better archery competitor. You can just be a better person. You can be healthier. There's literally zero
negative implications of doing this. You can diagnose things that you might have that you didn't know you had. I mean, it's absurd how much sense it makes for you to do it, even if you are only 20 pounds overweight or 10 pounds overweight. It resets your entire system. It cleans you out. And it gets you back to like the very basis of being a human being, being a hunter and gatherer in just what you just described. It gets you back to where you're supposed to be, at what the way your body's supposed to work. And I mean, so, and I also want to talk about, I'm going to switch gears a little bit. So last weekend I shot at Lancaster Archery Academy at their summer solstice. It's the first COVID shoot locally to be held. You know, we had one archer per bale and all this stuff, but it was like 90 degrees. And I had signed up for it prior. I really only started shooting 2 weeks prior. As I've been coaching the whole time, I have not been shooting. You know, do as I say, not as I do, unfortunately. But work, teaching, remote learning, sorry, I definitely was not shooting as much as I should have. While my energy level is up dramatically, my ability to sustain that energy level is not what it was. The reason being, and you and I had this discussion, is because it's such a low caloric intake day to day. I went to this tournament with extra water. We fast in the morning, so I didn't take any food, and except for apples. I took some apples with me. And I can tell you that with the fourth or fifth round of the first half, so you shoot 36 arrows in the first half, 36 in the second, I was spent. I was tired. And so I definitely wasn't prepared. So those of you that are competitors, and if you do consider doing this program, be advised. There are things that you can do, which Buddy will talk about. But there are things you can do to kind of help that situation. Second half,
Cramps.
Yeah, I started cramping up, and I got dehydrated. So I should have had it like Gatorade Zero or something with me. Probably should have taken food because it was a little after 12 or right around 12. But I didn't because I just thought, well, I'm fasting. I'm just going to eat when I'm done. I cramped right here at full draw, and it was horrible. It was the worst feeling, and it was like – this whole area just went, and then it stayed in a subtle cramp for the whole second half. It happened in the first end of the second half, and it stayed there. And, you know, I had to muddle through it and accept it for what it was. I would have three arrows go in the middle, and I would lose it as the ends went, and as the ends got deeper and deeper, it just, my ability to cope with it. So if you could consider doing it, and the reason I'm bringing this up is if you consider doing this, you can do it and still compete, but we're going to talk about how you do that and still compete and how you can prepare for it, because I wasn't prepared. I dropped the ball, but I didn't, maybe I was ignorant to it and maybe even should have reached out ahead of time. So what could I have done different to maybe prevent that? And understand, though, even as training, I noticed quickly, like six ends in with proper rest and everything on a practice, I was getting tired and shaky on because I was eating so little. Can you explain how can we manage this diet and still train? What are the options?
Sure. Yeah, the best way to prevent that would have been to tell me you were doing it. So that would have been part of it. But no, so it's a good question because we do have people that are in various types of training. Someone else in our group is training for, they were training for the New York City Marathon. I think they have canceled that, so it wasn't such a big deal. But there are definitely ways to help work around that. Now, when we're doing a reset like this, and like how we talked about how your body's either burning glucose for energy or can burn fat ketones for energy, that especially if your body's used to this burning sugar all the time, because we're always taught we'll eat like 3 meals a day and 5 snacks and eat every 2 hours to keep your metabolism up, you're basically training your body just to rely on glucose and burning the carbs for energy. So when we flip the switch and when we remove all those extra carbohydrates, especially the simple sugars, there's a transition period there where your blood sugar starts to go down a little bit and then your ketones have to ramp back up. But there are certain metabolic processes that have to take place and hormones have to balance out. So if you're a big carb eater, you're relying on carbs for energy, usually insulin's really high, which makes it hard to pull energy out of your fat reserves or burn your fat for energy. So I think we caught you in kind of that transition period where your body wasn't super efficient at burning those ketones, burning your own fat at the time. So things we could have done to help would be, I probably would have said, just eat some fruit every once in a while, give yourself some basically supplemental glucose through fruit. You could have eaten something like a root vegetable, perhaps Gatorade, electrolytes, because as we start burning fat and we're eating a lot less carbohydrates, we tend to, and we're drinking a lot of water, which we stress in the program because it helps with the hunger and helps you feel better. You tend to urinate out a little bit extra electrolytes. So that's fine if you're just kind of going through an average day and participating in normal activities. Like you can still go to work and do some light physical activity. You can go out, you can mow the lawn, you can maybe shovel some mulch. If you do what I did the first couple of days and dig like 12 holes for blueberry bushes, I was hurting too in that respect. So there are definitely some modifications you can make. Even with that, there are certain people that didn't want to lose weight on this program, but the lifestyle change, the fuel change, the food change was what they were looking for because they had something else like maybe IBS or thyroid issues. So there are ways to modify the program where we can account for a lot of those things. But you'd see that with any weight loss program. You'd see that with any major dietary changes and kind of just like perfect storm. You just kind of hit it at the wrong time. For people that are competing on a regular basis, there are definitely some modifications we can make if that is a concern.
Yeah. And again, my entire goal of this thing was to lose weight and to get to where my CrossFit, my optimum weight range is for CrossFit and Olympic weightlifting. I wanted to get back to that because I want to get back to in that workout format and then coupling it with my archery and try to marry the two so that, because before I was just 100% weightlifting and CrossFit. So, I just went all out. I don't want to do that this time. I want to use it as supplemental to my archery. Being on this, I noticed that though I was out, like I was painting my house one day doing yard work. A couple days, I go out on a fire call. I mean, we've had a ton of fire calls and I'm around during the day now. And like, if I go on like a strenuous fire call, like I can feel it. I know when I'm starting to like when my body's all right, you need to either eat something, get some water or get some Gatorade. Like I know it's up here. I know it's happening. You get a little lightheaded. You can see these things coming. So there are ways to deal with it. I did not deal with it properly. So this is your disclaimer. If you try this and then you just try to do life as normal, and if you're really active or you're training at something, you're going to go shoot, an R100 and shoot 100 targets in one day, it ain't happening. You're not going to do this eating regimen and then go do, go hunting for elk and walk 20 miles with a 60 pound backpack. You're not going to shoot a 72 hour round in 95 degree weather. It's not going to happen. You might be able to get through it, but it's going to suck at some point in time and probably sooner than later. So like, this is your disclaimer to say, if you do it, don't be like, oh, well, I would have known. You can do it. But then what's going to happen is it's going to inhibit the amount of weight that you lose. That will happen. That happened to me because I probably could. I think I misquoted. I think I'm at 37 pounds right now down. I started at 272. This morning I was 235, and we have four days left before whatever, I guess, maintenance starts.
A little bit about a week, but yeah. So that amount of weight. I mean, think about that. And yeah, you have to take 6 weeks to chill a little bit. And be honest, probably a lot of us could use that anyway. But throw on a backpack right now, throw 35 pounds in there. I mean, we used to do go ruck.
I know.
You take that backpack off at the end of the night after 12 hours of running around with that on, just 35 pounds. And it's like, oh my God, I feel so much lighter. I mean, yeah. Imagine now that, okay, you take that 35 or even 40 pounds or even more than that off. Like, and yeah, you had the chill for a month or so, but it's flown by. And
oh my God, how did that
work? With you guys, but it's still, it's flown. Like when you said 5 days left or 4 days, I'm like thinking like, no way, we have like 2 weeks left, but we don't. July like 2nd would be the last day, I think, if we look at the 42 days, or maybe I'm off a little bit, but yeah, it's almost over. And I always say that when I talk to people that are on the fence, it's like, look, you're going to see me posting stuff about the group in like 3 or 4 weeks, people losing all this weight. It's going to fly by. You're going to be like, wow, they're already almost done. And you're either going to be sitting there at the same weight, or you're going to be part of that group and sharing those successes. But yeah, as far as shooting goes, especially if you're a serious shooter, or even if semi-serious, saying that I always go by is the way you do one thing is the way you do all things. And if you let those things leak from your routines and just from your discipline, it's going to show you're going to be sloppy elsewhere as well. It's for me, it's like, and maybe this is my personality, kind of all or none. If I'm eating well, I'm getting exercise in, I'm doing my stretches, and I'm getting my water in. It's like, if I let one thing lapse, then it's like, I don't know, my mind subconsciously is just like, well, screw it, I'm not doing that right. So why am I going to bother with this?
Oh, that is such a perfect analogy with discipline and the shot process of barebow. You couldn't have hit the nail on the head any better. You know, if your eating habits and your approach to a lot of things in life are lackadaisical, if they are not disciplined, if they aren't consistent, and then you expect to just switch gears, pick up the bow, and for you to all of a sudden be spot on every arrow, it's just not going to happen. Sure, there's some that are going to be at the better side, the sunny side of it, but you're giving yourself a glass ceiling of not taking that approach in everything that you're doing, and it starts with your diet. It's like, it really does. Like, it starts with your diet and your sleep habits. Those two things, you can just improve those two things, everything around you is going to improve, especially when it comes down to performance in a competitive sense. It all starts with that one. And we talk about, there's always a baseline that someplace that you need to, focus on improving. Like in archery, we talk about your form. You know, I had a meeting yesterday morning with Larry Wise. Larry Wise is a level 4 archery coach, coached the Olympic Training Center, coached for 10 years, the junior dream team and stuff like that. And we were talking about target panic. And he said, he was like, it all starts with form. Everything starts with form. It doesn't, if you don't, it's that kink in the armor analogy. Well, what happens when you get really, really good with your shooting? Where's the next kink? Well, maybe it's physicality, maybe it's your strength, or maybe you need to take and look at before strength. What's before strength? Your diet, your food intake, your water intake, your sleep habits, overall health. You know, where do we start? Well, then it's time to start, you got to look at the bigger picture. And when you take and start improving all of those components, well, that glass ceiling starts to rise higher and higher and higher. And it doesn't matter what sport it is. It's any sport. And that's, I think that's the message that I've been trying to communicate with archery. Like, stop looking at yourself as just it's just your hobby. It's just your pastime. It's okay to have fun. It's fine. But if you want to act like you're serious about it, well, let's get serious then and talk about the important stuff. This is probably one of the biggest components that's never talked about in competitive archery.
Right, right. And I just want to mention it that kind of at this point in the conversation is that someone's probably sitting there saying, well, what the hell is the secret formula here? Or what's the big secret? There's no big secret. Eat meat and veggies, and the rest is kind of optional at this point. So meat and veggies, maybe a little bit of fruit, and don't eat too often. Eat less calories than you burn. The information part of it is so easy. You can look up diets. You can download diet plans. And if you can do that on your own and be successful with it, I don't care if you sign up for my program. I mean, this is how I make my living. But honestly, if I can influence you to see the change that I did, and you don't need our group or any group, then kudos to you and more power to you. But what I'd like to offer is that the opportunity to kind of fast forward your results, so to speak. And that's why I see a coach. And we're talking about archery here. You can go and learn this stuff on your own. You can watch some YouTube videos. You can do some drills. You can practice. And you might kind of limp along for months and months and months and maybe achieve or get to a point that you might have gotten to if you just hired Frank for a couple hours and he saw it right away what you needed to do. Your anchor point's wrong. It's like, man, that made all the difference. And it only took me like 2 hours instead of 6 months of struggling on my own. So that's what our program really is. It's a coaching program. It's an education. We give you the food list, black and white. Here's what you follow. That's kind of like coaching as well. It's kind of like personal training. You can walk around Planet Fitness on your own, just kind of wander in there and try to kind of make up a program on the fly. Or you can hire a trainer and then have a list of exact things to do. You get in there, you're more productive and you're more successful that way. Not to mention the accountability. So we have weekly calls. We have a Facebook group with over 180 people in it to help kind of cheer each other on and support each other. Jess and I have worked with probably 300, 400, 500 clients right now in this type of program. And we can troubleshoot pretty much anything. Like Frank mentioned, he had some issues, pretty easy to troubleshoot. We have people with various health issues, diabetes, hypertension, all sorts of, you name it, constipation, diarrhea. We can help troubleshoot that. So again, eat meat and veggies, eat less than you burn. You're going to lose some weight. You're probably going to feel better. Cut out all the processed foods and junk. So if that's the magic formula, or that's kind of the nuts and bolts of the program. But the real magic part of it is just being in that supportive community, that supportive group. Do you go to the range and shoot by yourself, or do you like shooting around others and pushing together? I guess that's the best analogy for this.
Oh, absolutely. You're relating it to archery, and that's exactly what it is. It's a community-based opportunity for you to get yourself healthy. And just in closing, you know, people, if you're still watching at this point on this vlog and you're paying attention, either A, you're super interested, or B, you're not one of those people that can do a group, your own reset and have the discipline to be able to do the research, watch the videos, read up on it, and do your own program. And you are the person. If you are still watching it at this point, however long we're into this recording, you are the person that right now I am talking to, and you need to go where, buddy, to sign up for your next session or the session that follows.
Yeah, real simple, groupreset.com. And we're starting one. I don't know when this will be released, but we're starting one.
This is going out today.
Okay. Then great timing. We're going to start right after 4th of July. So the first couple of days are loading days where we can eat whatever the heck we want. So what better time than July 4th and 5th, Saturday and Sunday next week. And the goal is as many calories as possible. So you can eat whatever you want there. And we start.
It's tough.
We didn't talk about that, but the loading where you can eat all that you
want. It's fun, but it's tough.
Artists and people, like, you don't want to eat for a couple weeks after that. So we're starting at July 4th, July 5th, groupreset.com. And we have a form there that you can fill out. By the time this goes out, I might have the link active. We don't have registration open as of this second, but I might by the time. But if not, there's a form there. Fill it out. Mention Frank. That's how you heard about us. And we'll get you started there. There's also a lot more information on that groupreset.com page. I think we have like an hour and 15 minute video that we did, a webinar that we did a few weeks ago. That gives a ton of information, a ton of free information on there too for those that want to try it out yourselves. We talk about the principles of a healthy diet, and we talk about everything that I did to help lose weight initially and what we include in the program. And but then for those of you that want that extra coaching, that support, if you want to maximize your chances of success, go to groupreset.com, sign up. And then once you sign up, we'll send some information. We'll get you a kit that has a booklet in there with the instructions. We have a journal. It's a recipe booklet. You get entered into our Facebook group with 180 people plus and counting. And then it's off to the races from there. And before you know it, it'll be, let's see, July 4th, it'll be mid-August. You'll be down probably max, not max, at minimum 20 pounds if you follow it correctly. And you'll be feeling a lot different, feeling great. And then you'll be like Frank here, telling the world, hopefully.
Yeah, we're literally telling the world this is going to be viewed across the world. I know it will. That's where our audience is. So
that's a good point too. We could see anyone. So this isn't a health. This isn't. I'm not diagnosed. We're not diagnosing. We're not. You're not becoming my patient or anything like that. So we're not really limited by borders. We can ship the kit anywhere. If you're international, get on it right away because it'll probably take a little bit to get to you. But yeah,
you can start late if you need to. But I mean, the goal is to start everybody together.
Yeah. Yeah. And we can we can work with anyone. All our meetings are our groups online through Zoom like this. Like me and Frank are using, we're using Zoom now. So we send you a link, you click on it, it opens up and you're participating in the meeting. Facebook, if you're on Facebook, Facebook group. It works.
Right. Awesome, man. Thank you so much for joining once again. It's your second time interviewing with me. I think I still may want to get Jess on at some point. She's got a lot of good things to say, and I think she might, you know, she's been doing this for a long time, and I want her to also to be able to talk about some of the other things, because she talks about like grounding. I've been doing that. You know, she's just so many other things that she throws out there that will help people cope with the change and stuff like that. So I definitely need to get her on, but thanks so much, man.
I like the informational stuff. I like explaining how the body works. I like explaining the information behind it, the physiology behind it. Jess and she's been doing weight loss specifically for way even longer than I have, probably 12 years now. She's worked with probably over 1,000 clients on her own. She's really good about the implementation part of it, like setting up your day to achieve success, because it's not just about what you're eating and what you, it's like, how do you make it? Like, how do you prepare to make it? Like, what do you buy? What do you, how do you prepare it? How do you put it away? Like, there's just a lot of like little things that people don't think about. It's like, you say eat meat and veggies, but then it's like, oh, I got work in 10 minutes and I got to eat. What do I do? Well, we try to, and Jess is really good at that, is at the implementation part of it, along with a lot of the extra lifestyle stuff that we share in the program. Because every week, the weight loss part of it, we teach that, the diet, we teach that in day one. We spend the rest of the time, all right, let's talk about sleep. Let's talk about improving sleep. Let's talk about getting proper exercise and activity. Let's getting out in the sun. Proper like bowel movement, bowel habits, and just eating properly. Like, who knows, there's a right way to eat. So that's all stuff that we just spend that 6 weeks. That's why we're now calling it the group metabolic and lifestyle reset, not just the metabolic reset program.
That makes complete sense. It's definitely a lifestyle change. It's definitely a lifestyle reset. So, all right, man, thank you so much. Everybody, you know what to do. Nothing's stopping you now. Peace.